He whispered in my ear and he pulled me up so close. He covered up my face. He said, I wanna let you know. Don't let the sun kiss you before I do. You know the sun sets every evening, but I'll never leave you. Hey, don't let the sun kiss you before I do.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today's video is a little different from the other videos, but since I don't have a niche and all of my videos are a little all over the place, it's not exactly anything different. I remember when I was working and I used to buy anything, or any of us used to buy anything, we used to, you know, assemble in one room and then show each other what we got, and then everyone would wear it one by one. It was fun, and in lockdown situations that is not happening, and I think a haul video is something like is the closest I can get to that feeling. Like, I had so much fun filming this. I was dancing, I had music on, and I thought I would show you all the things that I've got because I was so excited for them. And so let's talk a little bit about thrifting. So thrifting is something that, full disclaimer, I haven't been a huge fan of, but ever since last year I have actually stopped buying anything. And I don't know why, like, I took up this challenge called Project 333. If you haven't watched the video, please do. I will link it. So in that project, one of the rules was not to buy any clothing item that was a necessary. But I don't know why, when I took up the challenge, on the contrary, I felt like buying new things. And I don't know, maybe it was because I came across these Instagram stores that I was very, very much attracted to. And at that time I had this huge, you know, urge to, you know, buy something from those stores. And the first few weeks were fine, but by the end of the month I caved in and I bought something. I will make another video which will discuss all of my experience with the challenge. The thing is, I don't have all the 33 items with me right now in Dehradun. It's in Pune. So when I go back, I will make that video. These stores are pretty popular. I mean, so it felt like I was booking a slot for COVID vaccine. It's that difficult because they tend to run out so easily. So mostly I think they are young girls who are doing this, and it's so cool. They buy or have a consignment, I don't know, they get their products and then they model it themselves. Most of them, you know, click pictures themselves, they put on the clothing on themselves, like they are the model, and they do the, you know, planning, the pictures, the pricing, and the shipping and packaging and the support, everything they are doing. And if my hard earned money can in some way go to these small businesses and help them too, instead of all these gigantic companies that are already, you know, at the top, I think it's fair only. It's not bad. I mean, also the items that I got, I'm pretty happy with it. I think I'll definitely do it again.
Okay, disclaimer, I am very bad at explaining pieces of clothing, and that being said, let's anyways still try to explain all the clothing items that I got. So first is this cami top, little cami top. It's cute, I love the ruffles at the front, the color, the material, and also the packaging in which it came. So yeah, thumbs up.
Thank you.
such a fashionista in this outfit. I mean, wasn't monochrome the rage last year? I don't know exactly where. Anyways, talking about the pants, I love that these pants are not transparent. So the white pants that I bought turned out to be like a little transparent, but that's not the case with this one, thank God. But the store from which I bought this, actually this jeans was a larger size and they altered it according to my size, and I think they could have done a better job at it, but anyways, I still like the pants. Steps. These lookbooks are so long that we get bored and we put music on. But anyways, talking about the skirt, the slit, the material, the length, everything top notch. Also, just one basket, and I think it gives me that prairie chic kind of vibe. I just cannot wait for the next picnic date. I might just wear something like this. Between both the shoulders? Well, if you don't, yay for me, because one of the shoulder pads is missing. Actually, the store had mentioned it that one of the shoulder pads would be missing, but I just thought that a missing shoulder pad shouldn't be a reason for this beautiful top to not find a home that loves it. So yeah, I went ahead and bought it. Also, look at the buttons, guys. It has little hearts on it. I think that's so cute. Please take a moment to appreciate the collars on this shirt slash top. I mean, I fell in love with just the collars, and then I bought it, and I fell in love with everything else about this top. The shirt is from the same store as the one that I've shown before. This, I love the light puff sleeves on this shirt and the print. I guess it is called baby floral. Although I don't know, please correct me if I'm wrong, because I'm really having a hard time explaining all these clothing pieces. Anyways, I love the oversized look. I feel I can even tuck it in and it'll look good. It would look good over as a summer jacket, also with sunnies. I think this is what I would wear when lockdown gets lifted and I finally get to see my friends for a laid-back catch-up brunch date kind of situation. Also, I forgot to mention, but I am recording this from my new camera and I haven't properly figured out how it works yet. So please excuse me about the autofocus thingy that is happening here. Now let's move on and talk something about the top. You must have seen it in my Day in My Life part 2 video. Please watch it if you haven't. I'll link it. So I think this top looks great with jeans, but I wear it as a loungewear top. Also, you witness the smoothest transition in the history of transitions. Please acknowledge that. Anyways, so this says that it is from a brand called Topshop, And yeah, the soft satin material and the cute little planet star print makes it perfect for lounge wear. And honestly, I'm not even complaining.
And please let me know if you like such kind of content. Actually, I was waiting to do this video, but the fact that my male audience was more than the female percentage of audience, I was refraining from doing any such kind of video because I didn't want to scare the little amount of following that I had got. So now that my female audience is actually greater than my male audience, I thought this is a right time to, you know, throw in a little haul video. If you like it, any of my videos, do subscribe. I would love to have you. And with that, I'll see you next time. And till then, bye. He whispered in my ear, and he pulled me up so close. He covered up my face. He said, "Why you know? Don't let the sun kiss you before I do. Yeah, the sun sets every evening, but I'll never leave you."